Welcome to a sports betting podcast from pregame.com for the week of October 8th, 2009. I'm your host, RJ Bell. I'm joined by Marco D'Angelo, 30 years in the business, Vegas runner, a genuine professional bettor here in Vegas. This is segment 1 of 5, a free pick on the Florida LSU game, and then we're going to do a preview of the game too. First off, what we always do is get a line report from Vegas Runner. So give us a line report.
This one opened up off short, Chris, for the following week's games at 11.5. No one else opened it until a little later because of the Tebow question mark. And it opened up at 9.5 elsewhere as soon as Chris got a little money on the dog on LSU. So the line was pretty much 9.5. Dropped from 11.5 down to 9.5.
So at the 11.5, was it only one out that
had it?
So one book in the whole world had it.
That had it 11.5. The rest opened it at 9.5, but they also got LSU money right away and dropped down all the way to 7. I had seen it today. It's sitting around 8.
Okay. Now the whole Tebow thing. That's one of the reasons we picked. Well, it's a big game, but a nice reason that we picked this game. One of the games to talk about is the idea is how do you handicap injuries. So there's really two ways to do it. One way is you wait until the information's available. And you might have to wait 15 minutes before the game, but at a certain point, you're going to know if the guy's going to play or not. In the NFL, it's easier because they have an inactive list that comes out about an hour before the game, if I'm not mistaken, where you know if they're on the inactive list, they're not playing.
Play.
And if they're on the active list, chances are they're playing because why would they have them active?
Right.
So now, another way to do it is you bet earlier in the week and you try to project the likelihood of them being, of that player playing. It's really, if you think about it, almost mathematical. Any thoughts before I go into maybe the math of that, Marco, on how you handle injuries?
Well, in college, it's different than in the NFL. In the college, you don't always have that backup guy that can step right in. I mean, in the pro level, you know, generally there's going to be a drop off, but it's not as severe. And what I found in the NFL is the rest of the team takes it up another notch, you know, plays at a higher, you know, intensity level and compensates for the loss. At least
so you're
for
saying
that first
if you
week.
Know that. So you're saying if you know the guy's out,
yes.
What you've tend to see is the first week the public overreacts to them being out, and that's the week where the team steps up and replaces them. And they usually play better that week than expected.
Absolutely, and you're getting the better of the line value because of the public perception of the game.
Then what happens is in week two, if the team does do better than expected without them, if the person's still out, then the public says, oh, he's not that important, and then there's a letdown factor from the team, so it's a double whammy to then fade that team.
Absolutely. One thing to consider, the big thing to consider in this game is even if Tebow plays, Tebow is a quarterback that is such a big part of the offense, and the fact that he took a concussion, a very bad concussion.
Not his first either.
Will they alter the game plan?
Are you sure? Because I was hearing press reports are saying this was his first concussion.
See, and that's what I heard when I was talking to you about earlier when we were prepping for the show, that it isn't his first concussion, and that's what the worry was. So I don't know. I told you, there's a lot of rumors coming out. He is going to play. He's not going to play.
A lot of things with concussions, too, is that you don't always know. You always hear about these guys that supposedly have had 30 concussions.
Right.
But my point is that even if he does play, you have to think that Florida is going to alter their game plan because they're not going to have him running the ball like he does. I mean, he averages 14 rushes a game so far this year.
Wow, that's a great point. So we're saying if he even if he plays, he's not going to be 100%, and they're going to have to change the game plan.
Yeah, you're not going to want him to be running the ball and taking hits. And he's had 55 rushes this year for 271 yards and 5 touchdowns. He's accounting on the ground for 67 yards a game with his feet. Do you want to take that chance for him to, you know, I mean, he's fair game whenever he's a running back.
All right, so that's a great point. Now let's take a minute and talk about the takeaway that you had earlier about injuries in general. Is once a player is deemed to be out, look for the team to step up in game one that he's out, and the public to overreact to his absence, which means value on the team that's losing the player. Then in game two is the team lets down a little bit because you can only step it up so much, and the public likely is impressed in the way the team played in the first game, so you look to fade them. Now that's in game two. That's a very general, you don't do it all the time, but that's where you wanna always be looking to the under, you wanna be looking to the dog. There's always biases.
Yeah.
And you don't always bet the under, you don't always bet the dog, but I'd rather, like you said, play on the team the first game that they have an injured player out. That's a key player.
Later in today's show, or in a different segment when we do the Monday night game, we're actually going to be talking about this because you had that in the Miami game last week. It was the first game without Pennington.
Okay, that's a good point. All right, so actually, I'm the one giving my free pick on this game. So I'll talk about that first and let the guys counterpunch a little bit. Is I'm going with Florida here. And I'm saying play it now. And the reason to play it now is this Florida team is deep. And yeah, you don't just replace TiVo, but this is a very deep team. This is an LSU team that was getting 3.5 at Georgia. They played a good game, but let's be honest, this is a team that people are the wise guys are not super impressed with LSU. And here's the key to this pick for me is in this internet age where every piece of information gets old within 24 hours, no matter what happens, everyone's sick of it 24 hours later. People have been sick of saying how good Florida is. And the fact of the matter is, they're just as good as anyone thought. They haven't done anything to make you think otherwise. But there's just a general 1 or 2 point or 2 or 2.5 point adjustment, I think, downward here based upon talk that Alabama might be better or Texas might be better. It's just this internet age where everything gets old fast. People sick of saying how good this Florida team is. This is a great team, and if I can get this team where there's an injury bringing the line down and just the public's tired of it, I want to play Florida here. That's why I'm making it my free pick. Now, I am 3-0 on my free picks this year. I don't want to make a big deal about it. Well,
I want to
informationally
let them know
there.
You're riding the hot horse.
Exactly, because they have to decide who they want to back.
Exactly.
Speaking of that, Marco and I last week, for you longtime listeners or anyone listening last week, we made a nickel bet. That's 500 out there for the uninitiated. And, well, Marco lost. So we're going to have a payoff so everyone gets a chance to see it.
Yeah. Minus the VIG.
So talk about, as Marco's pulling out, yeah, as the cobwebs Here's and the bats fly out.
What I find interesting is exactly what you said, RJ, that the wise guys
you want to count it,
don't
sir?
Think LSU is that strong. And I think this move was more injury-related than anything else. I don't think it was steamed under. I mean, on LSU. I think it's just injury related, and they're compensating by adjusting the line and for the money that's expected to come in on LSU. Because LSU is 5-0. And let's not forget, in the AP poll, LSU's ranked number 4 in the country, and Florida's number 1. But when you look at the odds makers poll, they have LSU down to number 7. So the odds makers agree with RJ. This LSU team is not as strong as the public perceives.
Right, but that's pretty close.
Yeah, it's close. But I mean, they're not that top 3, top 4 team.
And maybe even their second, but this Florida team might be that much better. And that's what everyone believed early in the year. I'm not sure why not now.
According to their ratings, on a neutral field with Tebow in, Florida is 12.5 points better than LSU. So,
two quick notes for you. The last 8 games at LSU between these two, Florida 7-1 against the spread. And as I said about altering the game plan, now I haven't seen a total on this game yet because they were kind of waiting on Tebow. But if Tebow is a go, I think you might want to consider looking at the under in this game.
Because the game, the line would go up a little bit upon him starting. He's not going to be 100%. I think you're right. I don't think he needs to be 100% to dominate this game. And we're getting value because of the injury.
No, and they haven't posted a total yet.
Right.
They
I'm won't saying post wait
it.
Till
I made mine 41, so that goes with you. I don't think they'll put it out that low. So I'm looking at the under, too.
All right. Well, good stuff. Now, this is the end of segment 2. Or excuse me, segment 1. We're heading to segment 2, in which we're going to be giving you another free pick. And remember, you can watch all of our videos at pregame.tv, or if you want to download and listen, you can go to iTunes and search for pregame.com.